Republican Attorney General of Kansas, Kris Kobach, is angry. Get this. He is angry at the Biden administration. How dare they? For saying that they are going to invest billions of dollars replacing lead pipes around the country to reduce lead exposure for human beings. Kris Kobach and several other state attorneys general are angry about this, and they recently sent a letter to the Biden administration blasting them for this plan. At one point in their letter, they said, quote, "The plan sets an almost impossible timeline, will cost billions, and will infringe on the rights of the states and their residents, all for benefits that may be entirely speculative." So Kris Kobach says that, hey, the benefits of not being poisoned by lead, it's all speculative, right? Honestly, that actually sounds like the kind of statement that you would hear from somebody who's been subjected to lead poisoning, right? Pete Buttigieg, Transportation Secretary of the United States, did probably the best thing he has done since he's been in office this week when he fired back at Kobach on Twitter saying this. "The benefit of not being lead poisoned is not speculative. It is enormous. And because lead poisoning leads to irreversible cognitive harm, massive economic loss, and even higher crime rates, this work represents one of the best returns on public investment ever observed." So, top marks to Buttigieg and his response there, because he's 100% right. You've got these Republican attorneys general led by Kris Kobach saying, hey, the benefit is speculative. And Buttigieg is basically like, read a book, dude. Read a study. Like, this would be a massive return on investment. People would have less lead in their drinking water, and you're arguing against it? Now, Kobach, of course, was not happy with this response. He doesn't like getting shut down, so he responded to Buttigieg and said, quote, "What's speculative is that the admin's EPA rule will have any effect at all on lead and tap water. It doesn't touch the pipes in buildings where most lead pipes are. You'd know that had you bothered to click the link." So, under Kobach's reasoning here, it's better to just not replace any lead pipes than to only be able to replace some lead pipes. Now, it's been estimated that here in the United States, replacing every single lead pipe in the country, including those inside your homes, if you have them, would cost $47 billion. And in Biden's infrastructure package, he actually asked for $45 billion to do exactly that. Republicans came in and slashed the 45 down to 15. So Republicans took away the extra $30 billion needed to replace all the lead pipes in the country and not pass any costs on to consumers. Republicans did that. And now Republicans, led by Kris Kobach, are arguing that, what's a little lead poisoning, right? Why would we get rid of any of it instead of getting rid of all of it, which my party already said we're not going to get rid of all of it, but you want to get rid of some of it, and I say to hell with all of it. So, there you go, folks. If you're on the fence about which party to vote for in this year's elections, just remember, there's only one party in this country that's advocating for more lead poisoning, and that is the GOP. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.